One of the most common uses for line charts is to show the average of some data over time, but the average sometimes can be misleading. So for example, the average of 49, 50 and 51 is 50, but also the average of 0, 50 and 100 is 50, but those two data sets are actually very different. So it can be sometimes useful to have some representation of the variance or the uncertainty of your underlying data. One way of doing this is using error bars. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add error bars to a ThinkSol line chart. Let's get into it. So to illustrate how to use error bars in ThinkSol, we're going to use the example of an 8-week psychotherapy program that treats anxiety. Now we want to plot the average of the self-reported anxiety of all our participants, plus we want to plot the standard deviation of the results as our error bars. So to do this, we'll start in Excel. Here in Excel, you can see we have all our participants' self-reported anxiety scores. So the first thing we need to do is calculate the average and calculate the standard deviation. And I'll do that now. So next we need to format the data so it works in ThinkSol. Now we need three rows of data. We need the upper bound of the error bar. We need the data itself, the values, and we need the lower bound of the error bar. So I'm going to quickly calculate that in Excel right now. Okay, and that's done. So all we need to do now is copy and paste our data out of Excel and drop it into ThinkSol. So now you can see we have three lines in ThinkSol. Now to turn these three lines into error bars, we simply right-click on one of the lines and click on the button that says Add Error Bars. And that will automatically turn the top and the bottom line into error bars. Okay, now there's a few things we can do to the formatting to make it more clear. So first thing I'll do is remove the series label. Second thing is you can see the first error bar is sitting on the y-axis. We can adjust the spacing by right-clicking on the y-axis and hitting the button that says Set Crosses Between Categories. And now the spacing's improved. The y-axis is also the range is from 0 to 9. In reality, the scores range from 0 to 10, so we can adjust that to be more accurate. So now I think we need to add some data labels. So I'm going to right-click on the line and add point labels. And then I'm going to select one of the upper bound points, hit Control A, right click, and then do the same thing. And I'll repeat that for the lower bound, Control A, do the same thing. And now I'll reformat all of my labels by selecting one of the labels, hitting Control A, and Control A again. And now I'll reposition them. One thing I like to do is change the font and fill colors to make the error bars a little less prominent, so I'll do that now. And finally, I'll just label the y-axis and adjust the font slightly. And that's how you add error bars to a ThinkSol line chart. Just note, you can also do this in bar or column charts, which we'll go through in a different tutorial. But if you have any questions or comments, please drop them down in the comment box below. Hope that was useful.